So tonight we're heading out for another dive with BJ and Willie, a couple of locals, and we're going out to harvest a local delicacy from the sea. Painted crays, sliver lobsters, and crabs. Pretty much anything creepy and crawly running around on the coral is going to be coming into our catch bag.
So I was quietly terrified about getting into the water at night, but I felt safe with the people I was with, which was great. But as soon as I got in the water, once again, it was just nice and calm and peaceful, and I felt safe again. So Willie dives down and shows us how it's done immediately. So he goes and gets this big red crab.
The reef at night is a completely different place to during the day. For starters, all you can see is everything's concentrated into this thin orb of light of your torch. There's different fish species coming from the deep and are in the shallows. The parrotfish are all tucked away and sleeping in their little nooks and crannies. But for the crayfish and crabs, it's the opposite. By day, they are miles back in huge cave systems that go for hundreds of meters underneath the coral. I mean, you're pretty much wasting your time trying to go and get a crab or a crayfish during the day. They are so hidden away under the dark coral. But they've got to eat, and their chance to eat is at night. So we've just got to keep our eyes peeled for anything, particularly a little wee shining reflection of their eyes in our torches.
A little slipper lobster, also known as the Bort Bay bug. And apparently the most delicious little crustacean you'll find. And it's those little wee eyes that light up in your light that gives them away.
So these slipper lobster, they look like living fossils with their little red eyes sticking out, and they look bizarre. And I go and pick one of these up, and I can see all the armour plating this thing's got, and it's all spiky, and I guess if you're delicious, you've got to have something to protect you, right?
His eyes kind of stuck out.
Yeah, that's one of those tasty little treats on your own. Well done.
Yeah. Heading along in the dark, when you point your torch, things kind of jump out at you a little bit easier than they would during the day. And it wasn't long until I managed to find a little sea snake. So I've been told don't get between them and the surface. So I just go up next to it and have a nice look at it. It's awesome.
Being underwater here is just so different. Not just the clear water, the coral, or the different tropical species, it's the sounds. You can hear the reef. It's clicking, and you can hear the parrotfish chewing on the rocks, and the whales. Just there's this constant background noise of this most incredible whale song. It's otherworldly.
So BJ tells us the best place to get the painted crays is up in the shallows, and it's a little bit difficult because it is at night and you've got the whitewash and you've also got the coral and all the spiky things as well.
Now the painted cray, unlike the crayfish we're used to, can't be potted, and that's because they're vegetarians. So I don't know, unless you're going to chuck some tofu in a cray pot, these guys aren't going to be interested. So the only way to get them is free diving at night on a coral reef, which means that it's an extremely sustainable fishery, because let's face it, what we're doing now is not for everyone, and it's not easy.
Woo. They make a noise. They actually make a little audible squeal, and I don't know in the darkness out here whether that little paintedness of them is going to show up, but they're incredible looking crays.
So I was watching BJ pretty closely and seeing where he was looking for the crays, and he found his one under this little bit of coral. It's a little cave there, so there were these little antennae sticking out, and he just went down and grabbed it, pulled it up, easy as that, or so I thought. These painted crays must be delicious, because not only is BJ diving at night, he's in a cave, he's getting two crays at once, and of course he's run out of hands, so he's got the torch in his mouth, and he's lost his fin as well.
This one's a bit too small, eh? We'll let it go up, alright?
That one's a little bit small?
Yeah, this one's a bit too small.
So there's no actual size limit, it's just a bit of a thing that you do.
Just a bit of common sense.
Yeah.
Yeah. So,
maybe. Yeah, let that one go, bro. We'll go. This bag's starting to fill up.
everything was going great until I did a quick head count and noticed that someone was missing, someone slightly important. I head over to the shallows where Matt was and I see that he's holding his leg out. I'm not too sure what's happened to him, but upon closer inspection, he's managed to get hit by a sea urchin.
That's bad, eh?
So when Matt gets on the boat, we kind of see the severity of the sea urchin. So it's quite hard for him to get the wetsuit off because it's like completely stuck his leg to the wetsuit. So as soon as we get that off, the boys are like, yep, we've definitely have to get this treated with urine.
I just wanted to see if the pissing on yourself thing worked.
I knew heading out tonight I was going to be having a different experience. I just didn't think it would be an experience quite like this. This is not like a kinner spot, this is quite painful. There's a toxin being injected into my leg and spikes have gone in quite deep and they've snapped off. So it hurts a bit, but what's worse is everyone's about to piss on me.
Well, my booties are full of goodness. Here you go. Tip that onto it.
Awesome. Part of me thought they were joking, but no. We had piss coming from left, right and centre, all going over Matt's leg. I thought I had a strong stomach, but that was enough to make me gag.
Yeah,
this is some real piss,
bro.
Thank you.
That's it, mate.
Definitely not a highlight of the trip. I mean, everything's so great here in Niue, you know. You can be positive about everything, you just gotta look anywhere. I'm trying to see the plus side of this. I've got spikes in my leg, it hurts like hell, and everyone's pissing on me. But hey, everyone else seems to be having a good time.
You know what, I thought we'd be coming out from Painted Crazy and I didn't think my mates would be pissing on me.
I've lost my appetite, to be honest. Yeah.
The great thing about Niue is that everyone's so welcoming. You get to hang out with the locals, do the things the locals do, and the best part about this is that we get to eat this with the locals.